Sunday, July 10th, I think is the date today. Just giving you a quick update. I'm not really doing much of anything today. I'm just kind of looking around, getting a feel for the lawn and enjoying my time out here. But I did want to talk to you about an incident that I saw out here on my security camera, which I thought was kind of funny, okay? It involves this spot right here, okay? This is the corner of the property right here. All right, so right here, okay? Right here, there's a depression right here. Somebody drove their boat right here on the lawn, okay? They backed up their boat from here and then all the way back into here. So they took their boat all the way back into about right here. You can kind of see it because it's got a depression there. So it's longer, probably comes down maybe, I don't know, half an inch, 3/4 of an inch to an inch in places. Then there should be another check over here, probably about right here or something. Wasn't too bad on this side, more so just over here. This was on the 5th of July, so it's been about 5 days or something like that. And Sister Ward's like, hey, somebody drove on the lawn. So I went back and looked on the security cam footage. And I posted that on the Instagram as well. So it's right there. Right here, I have a hole right here. So I have a T-post right here, okay? Put a T-post in there. I pound that T-post in there. It's not in there now. But I pound a T-post in there and I put it in and put it out. Take it in and take it out every time I mow the lawn. And I just kind of put it to the side so I can mow right over the top of it. So there was a T-post right there and the guy backed right into it. The reason I have the T-post is so people don't come around this corner and cut the corner and ruin the grass there or turn it into dirt. So he obviously did not see the T-post and he doesn't really seem like he had a care in the world and just decided to go for it. So I didn't talk to the dude, she talked to him. But he was coming down this road right here, truck and trailer, okay, Dodge with a boat or whatever. Pulls into the neighbor's driveway right there, okay, because he's wanting to turn around, flip a U-turn. It's a pretty narrow road, not very big. So he goes down there, and then he backs right onto here, and then decides, oh, crap. So then he pulls over here and then turns and makes his U-turn. And in the meantime, he backed right over my T-post, and then hey, I thought I was going with you. Okay, go get me a shirt, I'll go with you. Here come some people. Gotta wait for these people to come by because they're so loud as they drive by. And they're just so happy, you know? They got the car full of stuff, wow. So he comes racing out of here and then pulls out here and he's drag. Because the T-post stuck under his truck. So he's like, oh crap. So I catch him on the camera coming over to the front door right here. So he rings the bell, come over to the door, and he's like, oh, hey, I just wanted to apologize. I hit your T-post out there. Really jacked it up. I'm happy to pay for a new T-post or whatever.
I just wanted to apologize. I hit that stake on your in the corner of the grass, and I hit it up. So I wanted to come.
That's really nice of you, because you know what? People do this crap, and then they just drive away. Don't worry about it.
You know what? I was just like so impressed with that guy. I love that guy. He's awesome. He is a class act. He had quite the hat going on, but man, I was impressed by that fella because majority of people, I cannot tell you how many times that T-post has been run over. So many times people just run it over, it bends it down to the ground, and they just drive off. But this guy actually had what it takes to go and apologize for it. And I have to give him credit for that, man. I was impressed by this guy. He goes in there and actually apologized and came to the door. So I was impressed by that. And so I want to thank him for that because most people just drive away. And here it is, you know, yeah, was I mad at the time? Maybe a little bit, but at the same time, it's not that big of a deal. It sucks and it's gonna happen. You live on a corner, these things are gonna happen. It just is what it is, you know? It's not that big of a deal. I can deal with it. I just wanted to show you that story. Mowed this lawn yesterday, it really does look fantastic. It's beautiful. And then my dahlias have started to spring to life. They're freaking awesome. Okay, I'm coming. I want to thank you guys for watching and also say, hey, it's not that big of a deal. You know, somebody drives on the lawn, it's just grass, folks. Grows back and we deal with it and it's going to be just fine. So that's it. Thanks for watching. I appreciate you guys as always, and I will see you in the next one.